Hi, I'm Captain Pat. I'd like to welcome you to the Captain's Meeting for the Tampa Bay Classic and the Tampa Bay Skiff Classic, July 22nd and July 23rd. Both tournaments are hosted by Billy Stonecrab and Tara Verde. I know you guys really like that place, good food, great service and super location. Good fishing right in that area too, as some of you found out. Let's get right into the weather. This is going to apply to both tournament series. There's a pretty good tropical spin up in the south, east, west, the eastern part down east of the Caribbeans on the Windward Islands area, and it is pushing up through towards Cuba. It probably is not going to be there for some time. Its maximum sustained wind has been 47 miles an hour, so it's not a big spin, but as it gets into somewhat warmer water, it could spin up a little bit, so we're going to keep a really close eye on that. Also, there's quite a bit of weather moving across from Texas to our panhandle, and that's not having an effect on what we're doing here in the Tampa area, so that's not a concern. The rain here on the coast in our studio area in Hudson has been cooking up around 4 o'clock, 6 o'clock by normal summertime weather patterns, rains for a while, then stops, and then it gets pretty nice afterwards. So I'm looking for that to probably happen on tournament day. I really don't look for any effect in our weather from the spin-ups in the far south in the Caribbean. We might get some pressure changes, we might get some clouds pushed up. It may work western on the southern part of the Gulf area and not affect us in the least. So we just have to wait and see on that, but we'll keep you informed. That's another good reason to have our cell phone number that's in the bottom of all of our communications. Have that locked in on your phone under the Kayak Fishing Classics or the Skiff Classics. It will ring into my pocket phone. And so tournament day, if we're having a weather issue or an emergency of any kind, you're going to receive a text. So turn your notifications up loud. So into a little bit of tournament fishing info. Both series are fishing for a Gulf Coast slant. Now, some of you new guys may not be totally sure on that, so I'll touch on that briefly. It's a trout, a redfish, and a snook. You can catch as many of those as you want, and log them in on iAngler Tournament app, and that will call your sizes out automatically for you. So as you accumulate big fish in the same species, such as redfish, for example, it will count the biggest catch, the longest catch of the day for you. Now, this is a slam tournament, so keep in mind that a three fish slam will beat a larger two fish catch. We've had that happen just a few times over the years, but it can happen, so be mindful of that rule. That rule is an etched in stone rule. There's no conversation about it whatsoever. Okay? Now, just so that you guys know that. Some of the new guys may have had some questions on that. So that's pretty simplified. Launch time for the kayaks and the boats is going to be about 6:15. We should have safe light by then. The boats can get their boats into the water and have to stay within 50 yards of the launch and then take off at launch time, 6:15. We allow the boats to do that simply because it's a lot more involved. You've got a truck, you've got a trailer, etc., and you got to get it off the trailer, on and on and on. If you guys in kayaks want to put your boat in the water and all your gear in it on the shore, that's fine, but don't paddle away from shore. Stay on shore, on ground, okay? Don't forget your entry photos. Everybody did that very well as far as their launch photos. So you take the picture of your kayak or your boat along with your measuring board with your token on it, click, and that's waterside or on the water right there where you're launching. And then you go to iAngler and you log it as a non-catch, no catch, non-species at 0 inches. Everybody did a great job on that, and I appreciate that. That makes my life a lot simpler when you guys do it all correctly. So thank you once again. So that's pretty much what we're doing. Tampa Bay, the fishing zone is for the kayak is all of Tampa Bay, Fort DeSoto, and a little bit southeastwardly, which I'm going to show you on the KFC zone map. The skiffs are a little bit different for Sunday. They are from Fort DeSoto, angling over straight across, and then upward into Tampa Bay. So they don't have the benefit of going to a little pocket area that the kayaks are. You guys can launch from any public accessible, allowable place. You can't launch it at your buddy's house because that's not public, right? So launch at all public places. You guys know that. We have a couple of new guys. Be sure that you have read all of the rules because there are zero exceptions on the rules. The rules are the rules are the rules, period. We've got some good talent coming in on the kayak side, some big guns coming in. Don't let that scare you new guys because you new guys have clobbered some of the big guns in here recently. In fact, a rookie won the last tournament, so and quite handily, I must say. So I'm going to turn the studio lights down a little bit, and then we're going to get into showing you the zone map and make sure that you understand that. Then we're going to come back and close out. Okay, so I'll be right back. Thanks. Okay, I'm back in the studio here, and we've got the big screen up here for you guys to see. As you can see, that's Tampa Bay. This is for the Tropic Bay Skiff Classics side of the tournaments for Saturday and Sunday. If you look closely, at the very bottom, there's a white double arrow pointing at each other. That's the boundary, and that kicks back in to the Skyway Bridge. Let me expand that a little bit for you guys so you get a good view. Okay? That is as far as the guys in the skiffs can go. So all of Tampa Bay, Fort DeSoto, then come out from the Skyway a little bit, and then the angle back up towards the Skyway when they get across the entrance of Tampa Bay and connect with the Skyway to the east. So that is your fishing zone. You've got a huge fishing zone, as you guys can see, so you should be pretty happy campers about that. Let's take a look at the kayak fishing classics. This is map is turned a little differently, so bear with me for a moment. You guys have all of Tampa Bay, and then down here to this bottom area, let me expand this, don't mean to make you dizzy, pardon me, so you guys have a huge zone. Pardon me. That is for the benefit of the kayak anglers if they want to, and that gives you a little more protected area as well. So in the event that some winds kick up, that's another option for you guys to consider. There's a cutoff on going up the river at 684, as you can see there. And then you guys can go all the way up into Tampa Bay, all of these awesome waters. Okay? So you have a huge area that you guys can fish. And you can launch, as I said, the kayaks and the boats both can launch wherever you want as long as it's public. So this is on this map is on the Kayak Fishing Classics tournament page, and then the Skiff Zone map is on the Skiff Classics tournament page. So I'm going to step back over here and turn the lights up here, have lights turned up, and we'll close out. Okay, welcome back. I hope that's helpful. We tried this our last tournament, and feedback I got was positive with using the TV screen and showing you zone maps here. And as I mentioned, they are on both websites, so take a good look at that and be aware of that. I did not post any launch maps. If you guys have been fishing long enough, you have all your own spots. If you need it, particularly on the kayak side, if you need some launch maps, just holler. Takes 30 seconds to throw them up for you. I'd be happy to do that. I cannot email those to you, but I can put them up on the website for you to take a look at. But there's so many places, you know, we would have had 40 different launch maps up on the website is why we didn't do that. Remember, it's a Gulf Coast slam. Slam beats two bigger fish. Two big fish is not a slam. It's fun, but it's not a slam. This is a Gulf Coast slam tournament. I know everybody's going to be doing good. Tampa Bay has been on fire. Those pockets here and there around the areas and the creek feeds, if you can catch an in-between rains, have been pretty good. All in all, the fishing has been very, very good. There are some muddied up areas because of the water runoff. That's to be expected. And then there's some fantastic areas. So study your currents and your winds and your look at where your creeks are. And that'll give you a lot of information. If you have questions, give me a holler. Send me a text is probably the best way. And if it's going to be a long conversation, I'll give you a call. So other than that, I think we're good to go. Be mindful of the weather. Bring your rain gear if you choose. I would. Make sure your cell phone's up to snuff, full charge and all that, and we're good to go. I will see you at 2:30 at the latest at Billy's Stone Crab in Terra Verde. Good luck, good fishing, wear your life jackets.